spend my whole life waiting in the dark, or left this place with a hole inside my heart. You came when I decided this might be my fate. Not one second early, not one second late. Tell me how you give me hope with just one kiss and fill my doubts with a love I can't forget. Oh, finally I breathe again. There are no words to describe it. There's no way that I can hide it. Oh no, finally the fear is gone and I don't have to face this world alone. Even though I lost my way with you, I'm finally home. There were times the pain was more than I could take. Somehow each and every scar has been erased. And if the sun and moon and stars come crashing down, I'll be in your arms, no safer place I've found. This is more than a simple memory I can't ignore. My dreams turn to reality. Oh, finally I breathe.
COVID, death of a family member, moving away to a new state, new careers. I mean, if I could put you guys in one word, it's resilient. So proud of you guys. And oh, I'm also surprised either, okay? I'm trying my best here. But it's an absolute honor to be here with you guys today. Stephanie, you look absolutely amazing. I know, I do. Stephen, thanks for being here. Dear family, we're gathered here today in the presence of the Holy Trinity, God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and their families to celebrate Stephen and Stephanie. They have boldly embarked on a lifelong journey nearly 2 years ago and are renewing their marriage vows before God, family, friends, and loved ones. Let us take wisdom in what Scripture teaches us about the two. On marriage. A reading from the Gospel of Mark, and Jesus said, "But from the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined by his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no man separate." On love. A reading from the Apostle Paul, the first letter to the Corinthians. Love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast. It is not proud, it is not rude. It is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered. It keeps no records of wrong. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always perseveres. Let us pray for the bride and groom as they prepare to renew their marriage vows. Heavenly Father, Lord Jesus, Holy Spirit, as Stephen and Stephanie pledge themselves to you, to each other, help them and bless them. Watch over and protect them. Bestow upon them a rock-solid faith, a desire to seek you in all matters, wisdom and guidance, that their love may be pure, their vows may be true, and that they grow to be a shining example of a Christ-centered marriage. In your perfect, precious, and holy name, Lord Jesus, amen. Stephen and Stephanie, as you continue on this lifelong commitment before God and each other, let me encourage you both what Scripture teaches us as our rules in marriage. Stephen, to you, unconditional love. A good husband loves his wife unconditionally and is a servant leader just like Christ. Husband's love for his wife should be based on her, should not be based on her actions. Wow. Let me repeat that one more time. Just so we've got that straight. A husband's love for his wife should not be based on her actions. He should respect, affirm, and love her at all times. This means to love your wife just as Christ loved the church. And leadership. The Bible makes it very clear that the responsibility of spiritual leadership in marriage falls squarely on the husband's shoulders. In marriage, being a servant leader means ensuring that your wife's material, emotional, and spiritual needs are met. Again, Christ is a wonderful example of this. He demonstrates servant leadership by washing his disciples' feet. And lastly, sacrifice. Sacrificial action is an integral part of the husband's role as the head of the home. To you, Stephanie. Be a helper to your husband. While all of us are called to be helpers to others, the Bible places a special emphasis on responsibility for wives. Genesis tells us that God realized it wasn't good for man to be alone, and that he decided to make a helper suitable for him. It is interesting to note that the Hebrew meaning for the word helper in the passage is found hereby in the Bible to refer to God as he helps us. The fact that the same word is applied to the wife signifies that women have been given tremendous power for good in our husbands' lives. Number two is respect and love your husband. In Ephesians 5:33, Paul says, "The wife must respect her husband. When you respect your husband, you reverence, notice, regard, honor, prefer, and esteem him. It means valuing his opinions, admiring his wisdom and character, appreciating his commitment to you, and considering his needs and values. And lastly, love your husband. Titus 2:4 calls for wives to love their husbands. A good description of this kind of love your husband needs is unconditional acceptance. In other words, accept your husband just as he is, an imperfect person. Stephen and Stephanie will now perform a stand unity. Separate lives together almost 2 years ago. The two separate bottles of sand symbolize your separate lives, separate families, and separate set of friends. They represent all that you are and all that you'll ever be as an individual. They all also represent your lives before marriage. Stephen and Stephanie have decided to write their own personal vows for the renewal. Stephen?
As I stand here before you, Stephanie, I couldn't be happier. Over the past years, my love for you has grown and matured. Through you and God's being within you, I found love, joy, and a partner who I soon realized I couldn't live without. Stephanie, before God and our families, I promise to love you and put your well-being and happiness above all else. I promise to hold your hand through the good times and the bad times. I promise to be loyal and faithful throughout my life. I promise to be honest and respectful. I promise to be honest and respectful as you help me grow and become a loving and supportive husband and future father. You are my equal and other half, and I cannot wait a minute more to be truly whole.
Hello, love. To say we have been through a lot is an understatement. You have been a constant support in my life through some major struggles, some difficult obstacles, and uncontrollable circumstances. You helped me get through these tough times with your love, support, and delicious cooking. This last year and a half as a married couple has been some of the best times in our lives. We got our first place together. I was finally able to start my career. We went on our honeymoon of a lifetime, and we traveled to so many other places. As we renew our vows today, I promise to continue to be by your side, to give you the immense support you continue to give me. I promise to continue to love you and show you how much you mean to me every day. You are everything I have prayed for in a husband and a best friend. Lastly, I promise I'll try to learn how to cook.
Thank you.
Keyword is try. I love you lots, mi amor.
Okay. We're almost there. So far you kept together almost. So you're doing a good job. Okay, we go now. I'm going to take one ring. See them. And have you repeat after me. I, Stephen, take you, Stephanie.
I, Stephen, take you, Stephanie.
For my lawful wedded wife.
For my lawful wedded wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold until this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
Until death do us part.
Receive this ring as a sign of my ongoing love and fidelity.
Receive this ring as a sign of my ongoing love and fidelity.
Stephanie, repeat after me. I, Stephanie, take you, Stephen.
I, Stephanie, take you, Stephen.
To be my lawful wedded husband. I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love and honor you all. Sorry. I will love and honor you all the days of my life.
I will love and honor you all the days of my life.
Receive this ring as a sign of my ongoing love and fidelity.
Receive this ring as a sign of my ongoing love and fidelity.
With great joy in my heart, it is an honor and privilege to now pronounce you husband and wife again. And now for the moment everyone's been waiting for, Stephen, kiss your bride. Let us all bow our heads and pray one last time. Lord, please bless, keep, and protect Stephanie and Stephen. Please let them continue to experience a lifetime of love, joy, peace, and laughter, and babies. Amen. Please let us celebrate, cheer and celebrate Mr. and Mrs. Stephen and Stephanie Bond.
We'll be singing. Girl, put some love on me. Yes, 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 yes